Hi there, my name is Irene, and in this video, we're going to be talking about SketchUp's groups and components. What do they do? What is the benefit of working with them? And what are the differences between both of them? So let's get to it. Alright, so in order to understand what is the difference between groups and components, we're going to need some raw geometry. So I'm just going to draw a simple box. There you go, that's box number one. So now I'm going to go three clicks to select the geometry, click, click, click. Then I'm going to go M for move, click to pick it up, control to make a copy, and I'm going to place that copy a little bit far from the first. Alright, so what we have right now is just two boxes that are purely made out of raw geometry. And again, when we talk about raw geometry, we mean the lines, faces, intersections, all of these basic elements that make our SketchUp geometries. And as we discussed in a previous video, the double-edged sword of raw geometry is that it is very reactive to each other. As soon as two raw geometries touch, they will fuse. And unless that, these can be great because it can allow you to very easily create very complex geometry. But for most intents and purposes, it can be problematic because once two geometries fuse together, it can be really hard to separate them, or you are just gonna ruin something in the process, all right? So this is where groups and components for SketchUp come in. Both of them serve the purpose of allowing us to isolate geometry. Basically, within the group or component, the elements are still raw, they're still interactive, you can still change them in whatever way you want, but they will no longer be able to be affected by anything that happens outside of that group or component. So the first thing that I want to do here is make one of these boxes into a group and the other one into a component. So you're going to see that the process is very similar for both of them. You're going to go one, two, three, right click, and you have the option make group. And there you go. We've made this guy into a group. And now for my component, we're going to go click, 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 right click, make component. So first of all, you're going to notice that there is the immediate difference that we have this creating component window. So this should tell you something, and that is that components are more parametric in the sense that they can carry more information than a grouping. A grouping is simply isolating geometry. Here, we're also isolating geometry, but we're also attaching additional properties and data to it. So I can give my component a name. Let's say that I want to call it box. I can give it a description. That description could be the general dimensions of the box. It could be the materials that the box is made of. It could be what is the brand or the collection. Like, you can put there any information that you want. Now, for the time being, I'm going to ignore these guys. Do not worry. We're going to come back to them a little bit later. These are a little bit more advanced. Funny enough, the advanced attributes are not that advanced. Advanced attributes are just, again, parts of the description. So if you're creating a component out of an actual real-world product, you can imbue that component with the properties of that product. So you can give it a price, you can enter the general dimensions, and you can even put a URL that takes you to the website where that product is available for, like, purchase or whatnot. Now, for all intents and purposes, the level of modeling that we're going to be doing, we're going to be ignoring alignment altogether. And for advanced attributes and descriptions, it's not that important. The most important thing when you're creating a component is that you give it a descriptive name and that you make sure that this option here, replace selection with components, is checked on. If this option is checked off, what will happen is basically SketchUp will create the component, but it's not going to show it on the screen. It's not going to be in the model space. Instead, it's just going to be stored within the file data. So to speak, you can still bring it and insert it, but that's not what we want. What we want is basically to convert this box into a component, right? So always make sure that you have that replace selection with components check on, okay? So I'm going to click here, create, and both of them look exactly the same, very anticlimactic. But this is important to understand. Just from looking, you cannot know what is a group and what is a component. From the outside, both of them look the same, and SketchUp doesn't give you any obvious clues as to which one is which. So the first thing is, how do we identify who is a group and who is a component? There's two ways that we can do this. One of them is entity info. Remember, if you want to access entity info, you can select the geometry, right click, and then click on entity info, or you can also find it on the default tray as a tab. So I'm going to expand this tab here. If you don't see the tab, you can go to extensions, window, default tray, and then entity info. So what you're going to see is that if you select a group, it's going to say that it is a group. If you select a component, it's going to say that it is a component. The other easier way to know if something is a group or component is that if you right click on it, if it's a group, it will say edit group. If it's a component, it will say edit component. Easy peasy. All right. So now that we know how to create groups and components and we know how to differentiate them, it is time to talk about what is the actual difference between them. Why do we do one or the other? So in order to understand this, what I'm going to do is I'm going to select both of them and I'm going to copy them once more. So these two guys are groups. These two guys are components. So the main difference between groups and components is the relationship between the originals and any subsequent copies. In groups, each group is its own independent entity. So, for example, if I go to edit this group, click, click. So we're talking about internal editing, the kind of editing that requires to be inside the group or component. If I edit this group, you're going to see that my copied group, it doesn't change at all. If I edit my copied group, you're going to see that the original is not affected by that change. But components are all related, and it doesn't matter if you change the original or the copy. Both of them will change. See? So if I change the copied component, the original will change. If I change the original component, the copied one will change. They are all linked together. They are all related. You can think about SketchUp components as AutoCAD blocks, or you could think about them as Reddit family types. So when you make a type change, all of the instances within the type change. All right, so this leads to the question, well, why do we have that? Why do we have groups not changing and components changing? And the idea here is that you must always isolate raw geometry. Remember, we talked about that before. You should never have raw geometry in your model. But depending on the purpose and the use of that geometry, you may choose to isolate it as a group or as a component. So that being said, there are basically two camps in my experience when it comes to using groups and components within the industry. There are people that use groups and components, and there are people that use only components. Everything is turned into a component. So why would we work with either of those systems? So if you're going to be making everything into a component, the idea is that because components carry more information, it can sometimes make it easier to work with that geometry. The con of this method is that you have to be careful because sometimes you're going to want to make changes to one of the copies that you don't want the rest of the copies affected by. In the case of working with both groups and components, basically the logic is asking yourself before you isolate that geometry, is this geometry going to be more than one off in the model? If the answer is yes, it's a component. If the answer is no, then it's a group. So for example, if you have like your house entrance door, that is just going to be one main entrance door, so that could be potentially a group. But for example, the inside room doors, they're usually standard, so those would be components because they are elements that repeat. So the idea of using both groups and components is that groups are for one-off instances and components are for geometry that repeats throughout the model. Now, there's a few more things that I want to explain both about groups and components. First thing first, what if you change your mind? What if you created a group and you want it to be a component? What if you created a component and you want it to be a group? So first a group. Let's first make a copy of this thing. At any point of your modeling process, you can select a group, right-click on it, and make it into a component. And one important thing to understand here is that it's not like you're going to have a group and then that group is going to be inside a component. No. You are changing the designation of the grouping. So you're switching it from being a group to being a component. So if I come here and I say make component, I'm going to call this guy group box, for example, and I'm going to press enter. The reason that I'm explaining this, if you go into edit mode for the now component, you're going to see that you're accessing directly the raw geometry. It's not like we're going from the component to the group and then into the raw geometry. The other thing that I want you to keep into consideration is that this is a change that only works going forward. So what does that mean? Well, that means that once you convert a group into a component, any subsequent copy of that component will be affected. So you can change the original and you can change the copy, but it will not retroactively change previous copies of the same group. So remember, this guy and this guy were the same thing. They were originally a copy of the same, but because they were groups, they are completely disconnected. And the reason that I am being so specific about this is because the worst thing that can happen to you is to have a bunch of repeating elements and then realizing that all of them are groups. You cannot select all of them. So see, for example, again, this guy is a group, remember? So I cannot, let's say I'm going to make X5, 5. I'm gonna make a bunch of them. If I realize that I actually wanted these guys to be components, I can't just select all of them and say right click make component, because then what it's going to do, I'm gonna call this guy grouping. What it's going to do is create a component that contains all of these groups. So you have to be really careful with this. And I'm talking from experience, like this happened to me once. I was working in a restaurant project and I had put like all of the chairs in the model. I don't know, it was probably like 50 chairs. And then the client came and they said that they wanted to make a change to the chair. I think that they wanted to change the fabric or something. And I went in to make the change and realized that all of the chairs were groups, which basically means that then you have two options. You can either change the materials in 50 chairs, or you can delete the other 49 chairs, take the one chair left, make the change, make that chair into a component, and then place again that chair 49 times. So what I'm trying to say here is that if you have a group and you want to turn it into a component, you have to be very, very aware. Because if you realize this too late, it's going to be very annoying, it's going to be very cumbersome, and it's going to cost you a lot of time. So again, to reiterate, if you take a single group, you can convert it into a component. But if you take several groups and you try to make a component, what you're going to do is create a component that will contain those several groups. Now, what if we want to go in the opposite direction? What if I change my mind about a component and I want something to stop being related to all of its siblings? Let's say that I select these two boxes and I create a copy of them, and I decide that I want this one guy to be different from all of these other three guys. Well, in that case, you have two options. Option one, you could potentially explode the component and then convert it into a group. That is not necessarily my favorite method. Again, I tend to be very cautious about exploding things, especially when you're just getting familiar with SketchUp. So instead, what I would recommend is the option make unique. So what make unique does is maintain the component, but make it a different version. So what does this mean? Well, I'm going to expand here my entity info. And what you're going to see is that if I select these four guys, all of them are box, right? But if I come here and I right-click and I go make unique, what you're going to see is that this guy is now box number one. These guys are still box. This guy's box number one. So what's going to happen now, let's make another set of copies of these elements. What's going to happen now is that this guy's still a component. So if I make copies of box one, both of them are going to be related, but my original box is now a separate entity. So basically you keep the component benefit, but now you're creating a new iteration, so to speak. This is my preferred method, to be entirely honest. And the other thing that I really like is that you don't have to select one component at a time. So for example, let's say that I've decided that I want these two guys to be new offshoots, but I want them to be related. Well, same thing. I can select both of them and click on make unique. And what you're gonna see is that now both of them are box two. See? So you can break off from a component, one component or multiple components at the same time. So see now, again, if I copy these guys and I go here, all of them are related, but they are separated from these original component. So as you can see, there's a lot of different ways that you can mix and match. The other thing is, and I think I already talked about that in previous videos, when we were doing our multi-level house, but you can have groups within groups, components within components, groups within components, components within groups. So all I need to do is select whatever geometry I want to group together. And again, I keep on using the word grouping because it's the best word that comes to my mind, but it could be a group or it could be a component. So I can right click and, for example, decide that I want this selection to be a group. And then I can come here and say that I want this other selection to be a component. So let's say that this is going to be a big component. Very creative names, I know. Okay, so what's going to happen is that if I copy these two elements, let's put them here to the side. Because this one is a group, I can change it without the copy being affected. But because this two are components, if I move one, I move all of them. And this is how we can create very complex geometry in SketchUp. The way that you want to think about it is, instead of just making one single raw geometry entity that contains all of the details of all the things that you want to see in the model, what we do is that we make smaller, simpler groups and components, and we kind of configure them together. So what's going to happen is that we are going to group geometry now, not just to isolate it from the rest of the model, so the raw geometry is not affected, but also to kind of manage the geometry that we've created. So if we want things to go together, we group them. So you can think about, for example, if you have a chair, the chair has four legs. So a single leg could be a component that then is copied three times. The seat of the chair could be a group. The back of the chair could be a group. Then the chair as a whole could be a component because chairs are usually going to repeat at least a couple of times. Imagine that you go through the same process with a table. So you have a table, you have a chair. If you want those two things to be together, you make them into a group or component. If that table and chair belongs to a restaurant, then it would be a component because there's going to be multiple of them. So that's the logic. We use groups and components first to isolate geometry from the rest of the model, but then to group elements together. And then the decision of whether we use a group or a component will be based on whether that object repeats or not across the model. And with that, we have reached the end of this video. I hope you found it helpful. If you have any questions, by all means, feel free to add them in the comments. But otherwise, thank you very much for coming in. Thank you very much for sticking through, and I will see you in the next one. Have a good one. Bye.